Respected resource person of the day, Dr. S. Gokulraj, my dear staff members of my department, and all participants, a very good morning to each one of you. On behalf of the Department of Electronics and Communication Science, Hindustan College of Arts and Science, I, Ms. D. Jayanti Margaret, head of the department, take utmost pleasure and happiness in welcoming each one of you to this webinar on requirements and strategies for a successful research. So firstly, I would like to thank our resource person for having accepted our request to handle this webinar, and was really overwhelmed looking at his enthusiasm and cheer in handling such webinars, sharing his knowledge and expertise across the globe. So at this juncture, I would like to introduce the resource person and give a brief insight of his profile. Dr. S. Gokulraj is currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Physics in Kandasamy Naidu College, Chennai. He has served in various capacities in the past as associate professor, young scientist, etc. in reputed institutions like Veltech College and National Institute of Technology, Trichy, respectively. His career boasts of a rich expertise in teaching and research. He was elected as fellow of the Academy of Sciences Chennai during October 2015 and is a life member of Indian Physics Association, Magnetic Society of India and Indian Science Congress. He has an H index of 15 and has many publications in Scopus indexed international journals and has presented many papers in national and international conferences. He also has been actively serving as the resource person in many national and international workshops and FDP programs. Adding feather to his cap are his two funded research projects funded by DST and DRDO with a whopping grant of 18 lakhs and 26 lakhs respectively. Apart from this, he has authored many books, served as member and examiner in many academic bodies, and has been appointed as an observer for many national examinations by MHRD, CBSE, and NTA. So this is his profile, which actually was running, but I have put it in a nutshell, and it's indeed a great blessing for us to have a person of this stature and caliber in our midst as the resource person. So I once again extend a hearty welcome to you, sir. And with no further ado, I hand over the session to our resource person, Dr. S. Gokulraj. Please, sir.
So welcome to all. Today's session will be on requirements and strategies of a successful research. First, I would like to thank the Department of Electronics and Communication Science of Hindustan College of Arts and Science, who has been hosting this webinar. The Department of Electronics and Communication Science has been enthusiastically involved in many such activities for the welfare of both students and as well as teaching and research community. At this juncture, I would like to thank the management of my institution, Kandasamy Naidu College of Pachaipas Trust Board, and also the Hindustan Group of Institutions for providing a fruitful opportunity to share the knowledge. Now, let me quote Swami Vivekananda's quote. This is quite suitable for us during this juncture. True guidance is a small torch in a dark forest. It doesn't show everything at once, but it gives enough life for the next step to be safe. So, our step in involving this webinar for introducing about the requirements and strategies of a research doesn't show the whole of a torch for the dark forest. It shows light for us for the next step. And if the webinar justifies the content and if it reaches the people so that they are able to make the next step, then I hope that the webinar is definitely a successful one. And we would like to thank the host institution and my institution for providing to take part in this opportunity. Now, let me straight away go to the funding agency. As we all know that Department of Science and Technology is the forefront in carrying out all the science and technological development which is happening throughout the country, which is headed by Honorable Sri Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Minister of Science and Technology. And if you go to the DST website, it is dst.gov.in. Whenever you are going to write a proposal or strategies, whatever it is, first you should be knowing that what is the current thrust area? What is the thrust area that government has announced and that which is quite suitable for your area? And when you have to match both this, you have to definitely look into the thrust areas. So then and thereafter, the government announces the basic thrust areas. So in the website, if you go to the electronic project management system, there you can have your individual profile updation or institution profile updation. Then in the second instant with the green arrow mark, we are having fellowship opportunities for researchers, whether it is a young researcher or next level of researcher. The next is schemes, which is available throughout the year. So what are the schemes available? So these are the things first we should be knowing it. The next one is project management system. If you go into the project management system, you can log in and you can create username, password. So whatever, when you go in for a email ID, for a password, Gmail, you look, you give your date of birth, what is your profile and all. The same thing applies here. So you are going to make it as a e-project management system. Then the science and technology has broadly classified most of the scientific developments that is happening in and around the country. Now you see, we have Science and Engineering Research Board, Technology Development Board, International Collaboration, Technology Mission, and Women Scientists. So few of the schemes we are going to highlight, and then we are going to see what are the schemes that is there for related to the materials or physics, chemistry, whatever it is. You are just going to see the thrust areas, and then we are going to see what is the strategy in adopting a research proposal. So this talk, in the first session, in the first few slides, we'll be discussing about the same science and technology and its thrust areas. And in the later part, we'll be dealing about the research proposal models, right? So next, when you go for the science and engineering, you see that we are having INSPIRE, FIST facility. FIST, which is for the institutes, SAI facility, the science and technology for yoga, meditation, science program. Then it is for senior research fellow, Swarna Jayanti fellowship. Then you have science and engineering research board. Science and engineering research board, it is a common for both engineering and science. The science covers mathematics, physics, and chemistry. So it covers all the topic. So when you go for science and engineering research board, you have to go into its webpage. So scrb.gov.in. Then you see that we are having an online proposal system. There also we are having a common online system. And then and there, science and technology will announce thrust areas and it will be displayed at the what's new corner. So this is where you are going to log in, and this is where you are going to have the newer proposals. Then what is the schemes and programs available? So because when you are going to have any of the stream, let it be a physics stream. Physics stream itself consists of general physics, nuclear physics, material science from Anna University or PhD Tech Coimbatore, electronic science from Madras University, and of course the institute, your institute. So Hindustan electronic science, and most of the colleges, they make interdisciplinary such as electronics, material science, and also physics. So we have lot of core research areas where the thrust areas are announced, split up, and it is divided, subdivided into different categories to suit each and every individual research corners. So now, scheme for funding industry relevant. So it is not only the scheme for a research. Ultimately, the research, it should reach the common man. So for reaching a common man, It should obviously be an industry-related program so that it is commercialized for future. So there is also a scheme. So for this, we need an academic partner and an industry partner. So academic in the sense, we belong to the institute, of course, like my institute or Hindustan or your institute, any universities, colleges. And obviously, we should have an industry partner where our research proposal can be commercialized, the possibility of commercialization. So this is the technology development. So when you want to transfer the technology to the common public, it can be industrial oriented and also technology oriented. So these are the various schemes that is available in the technology development board, right? The next is technology mission. So when we go for a mission project, they are broadly classified into water initiative program. Of course, water initiative program is the one where physics, chemistry, and electronics people have lot of scope. So this technology development mission is an important scope in the areas for physics, material science, electronics, and as well as chemistry. For example, if you take a water technology initiative program, it involves what is the water treatment methodology available, then improvement in the technology, as well as the fabrication of the components. So with the physical phenomena, a physics person is involved in the synthesis of materials, chemistry people are involved in the fabrication, as well as the chemical material synthesis. Then the instrumentation fabrication part, electronics people is the one where they are going to carry out in the small scale or a very large scale integration. Like VLSI, you are going to go for a large scale process. Then clean resource energy initiative. So energy initiative, nanoscience and technology, and supercomputing. Supercomputing is the one where it is mostly for computer oriented people. And of course, nanocomputing is also one where recently it has gained momentum. Nanoscience and technology initiative, any general people, for example, whether it is a physics, chemistry, electronic science, material science, or engineering discipline, mechanical, electrical, these disciplined people can participate. So these are the, then regarding to the thrust areas, if you consider the thrust area, science and technology, it has again subdivided into some of the categories, nano, optical physics, low condensed matter physics, development of lasers. So when we consider development of laser and its technology, physics and electronic people combine together, they work and they do create lot of electronic kinds of material. Then it is engineering sciences, where electronics and engineering sciences combine together, they can work in these areas. For example, optics, computing, and nanosystems. So these are the some of the thrust areas. Apart from that, you have turbulence mechanism. Then the important area is industrial oriented area. You see that we have system analysis, robotics, automobile, aircraft, biological system, algorithms of VLSI, very large scale integration, and bioinformatics. So these areas, electronics and computing people work there as a lot. To the next stage, right? The next is micro electromechanical devices. So these micro electromechanical device and energy engineering, engineering people such as mechanical, electrical people, and also from the electronic sciences such as BS electronic science, MS electronic science people, they have a lot of scope in these areas. So these are the thrust areas. For example, so how do we, the government identifies the thrust area and what is that really thrust area? Now we are given what is the funding agency, what is the thrust area? So let me give you an example. So if you consider IIT Kharagpur, recently they made an innovation in COVID-19, so which is a need of the hour. They made a disinfection chamber. The chamber, it can control some of the access. So the IIT Kharagpur, they have successfully implemented it and they are going for industrialization and also for commercialization. So this is one area. And you know why there is a need for a disinfection? Of course, whenever one patient is cured and when he's shifted to back his home or a quarantine place, the affected area should be disinfected. For example, another people, they have just fabricated an our robotic UV hospital room disinfectant system with a sensor navigation. So with the help of sensor navigation, definitely we can go for unmanned areas. For example, if there is a mechanical system, and of course today's research proposal we are going to deal about the robotics mechanic system. So whenever there is a robotic mechanic system, definitely robot are not going to get affected by COVID-19. Of course, when they come out of it, we can easily disinfect it, and they are not going to get affected by the virus, right? Or bacteria, any of the infection. So now it will be very easy if it is robotic based. So in that area, these are the areas where government look into it and form a committee, and they announce thrust areas in this region, right? So when you go for a funding agency, if you consider this, it is called IMPRINT, Impacting Research, Innovation and Technology, which is under MHRD. You see that we have lot of projects which are going on. For example, you see that we are having dynamic mechanical analyzer, water pollution system controller. See, water pollution is a major area where we have to make a lot of devices where water can be recycled, filtered with removal of bacteria or virus in it. So it is an important area. So air pollution is also one where chemistry people are working in it. So these are the some of the research proposals. So we are going to have in-situ mechanism, magnetic nanomaterials, reusable catalysis. So these are the some of the IMPRINT technologies that has been adopted. So if you go for a IMPRINT Research, Innovation and Technology website, you can definitely see the website login details so that all the necessary information are there provided in the website. And of course, I have given the website details also. And the link also will be giving. So these are the some of the thrust areas. Now, the first part we have just seen, what is a funding agency? So in the funding agencies, we have always discussed about the funding resources, who are giving, what is the thrust area, and how do they define the thrust area, and with the thrust area, what are the fundings given in present situation. So now we are going to see what is the thrust area based upon, what is the thrust area. So how do we apply for this model research proposal? Of course, I have given a model research proposal and the strategies in implementing it. So now the first question arises is whether I have to go for a practical, that is experimental or theoretical. It's a big question. So whenever some person has completed his post-graduation, he always thinks about it. And of course, I started with the theoretical model. Later on, I shifted to experimental, practical researcher. It all depends upon the area which you are going to work, the choice of work, and also it depends upon what are the available facilities and also the research guidance under whom you are going to carry out. So you have to decide it on which side you are going to start. So now, in the proposal, in the model proposal, I am going to highlight both theoretical and practical combined together in the later stages, right? So now, if you choose your research area for a cartoon, just I made it, like Heisenberg uncertainty principle, it is always an uncertainty. So you start up somewhere, you travel nowhere, and you end up somewhere. So it is a tricky one. So how do we need it? Just for a cartoonic representation, I have made this Tom and Jerry model. So a good research question needs to be make sense. So first thing is, in other words, you must clearly define your terms. You have to define your literature and your research question. So next is, what does we need to address? So what is the issue that I am going to address? So a good research question will always have a relevance of time place and the popularity. So you have to go through the model where currently you are able to implement it to the best level. So for example, you are going to study about vitamin A deficiency in South India or somewhere. It will be a poor choice, and as this is not a particularly significant problem in that area. So you, what then if you are going to make a study about South India, then what we need to do, at least for sampling, if it is a biological or biotechnology, you are going to make simulation or not, definitely for simulation parameters, we need to go for sampling analysis. So if you are going to go for South India, you need to go for every part of South India so that you take some analysis, then you need to conclude it in terms of biology. So choosing a broader area makes your problem very worse, right? And then whether I need to find out a new formula, new method, it can be anything. It's not that it has been already done. A research goal study will be just like a novel. This means there'll be some new aspects of the study that have never been examined. The aspect, in the sense, it'll be different dimension. For example, if your people are working on material science, they do synthesize on different kinds of combinations of materials. So for that, I have just made a cartoon of that Tom and Jerry, from the Tom and Jerry cartoon. You see, it is going to make different compositions, combinations. It's just a trial and error. So they go on, make some of the combinations. So it can be newer method, it can be newer compositions, it can be anything. However, this doesn't mean that you should avoid replicating the past research. Past research citation can be taken as it, and it can be adopted as a methodology, but you can add new things, novelties, so that you add up some weightage to your research. Then next thing is operational size. And of course, you should have, whenever you are going to make a theoretical survey or experimental, you should have a necessary tools. For example, if you are going to have a theoretical model, then you should be able to have the softwares. If you are going to go for experimental, then you need to go for some of the smaller techniques, such as, for example, I have shown some of the beakers, petri dishes, chemistry labs, or something like that. So you need to have a smaller space. Then next is with a reasonable scope. So you should have a depth and breadth of the research scope so that you can solve the problem then and there. Then you can carry it forward. For example, a study that identifies the relevance of eye disease in a specific village is more likely to succeed than comparable than a eye disease which is prevailing in the world population. So whatever the data you have, it is always better to have the next step. Then if you are going for a theoretical model or an experimental, please do stick on to the research area and don't wobble between here and there. So I have seen many people who have faced much difficulties. So when you start up your research, be clear and be specific so that your research proposals get to the next stage and your research will make it to the next stage. Make a survey about the research area and also about the available facilities around you so that you don't stuck up anywhere. So you should definitely make a literature survey before you are going to enter into the research area. Next, let's just choose experimental with analysis. Analysis such as it is just a theoretical model. Then if you are going to choose a theoretical model, the next question is, where is the lab and how big is your lab? So whether you are able to synthesize the samples in your lab or with the help of your friends or somewhere where you can have your collaborative research work. So when you deal with physics, material science or electronics, a lot of research scope are there wide open. So today's world offers you anything and everything. So if you consider this Qualcomm technology, of course, It is a robotic based one, which is recently, only a few days back, it has been released. So you can have a robotics based electronics or the material fabrication. If we consider any robotics, then the robotics involves what is the material that you are going to use in the robot, then what is the mechanism, then you are going to make a programming. You see that if you are going to have a robotic system, then what is the best material you are going to use? The next is, what is the component that you are going to use? Then is theoretical and experimental simulation. So whenever such field are exploited, you have lot of scope. So in that area, I have just taken an experimental, which is combined with theoretical model analysis, which DST has given as a model proposal. So just we are going to explain that. So now, and if you go for a material science research, you have macro, micro, and nanotechnology, which includes biological systems, any plant biotechnology, or animal biotechnology, or human applications. Then, the next is the terms. We see that many terms such as hypothesis, materials, procedures, what is the conclusion, research, we do here day to day when you face on to the research area. So now, we should always think that what is the ultimate aim? See, for example, here I have given many cartoon animated pictures, right? Obviously, what is the need for having different animation pictures? Obviously, it should entertain kids or people who are watches it. That is the ultimate aim of a cartoon network. Let it be any character which Disney created or any people who has created. So the ultimate should be, aim should be deliverables which should reach the common man. Like that, the research, whatever research we are going to carry out, it should always have an aim, and at the final moment, we should be able to deliver whatever the research guidance or any format we have given, right? So next is choice of proposal and methodology. Now we are coming to the topic, what is the choice of the proposal? So now we have guided you, what are the thrust areas? Suppose if you are a postgraduate in a physics or a material science or electronic science, obviously you can go for nanomaterials or electromechanical systems, MEMS, NEMS devices, or if you are going to have a mechanical systems, you can go for mechanical. If you are a chemistry or a chemical engineer, there are a lot of catalysis, chemical reactions, some of the water technology, purification technology, lot of topics are available. So the researcher must first identify the goal of a research. So the goal of the research should be fixed based upon their own specialization. For example, if they are going to have studied at physics, then they go and go for interdisciplinary research. If someone is going to go for chemistry, they can also go for interdisciplinary. If someone has studied mathematics, then they can go for mathematical modeling. If someone has studied electronic science, such as Hindustan is offering, then you can obviously go for electromechanical systems, which can combine electronics and physics. So first, we should go for e-resources such as PubMed, Google Scholar, which is more than sufficient. It can give you n number of lakhs and lakhs of your articles, research articles. Lastly, many research ideas are generated through dialogues. So how do we either? We can discuss with the professors, fellow students, or researchers, or a family member who can guide you. Then define your topic. So after you choose your topic, you should first, in a crisp, define it, how it starts with a relevant topic. So that is the interesting part. And also, if you have chosen and sticken to it, you should progress in the same line and length. Then narrow down the topic to something more specific, right? Then you need to go for literature review. So literature review, it can be a journal article where we have opened our website, web source resources are a lot of fun resources which can give you journals. Then you can go for thesis, dissertation of your seniors, professors are available from the web articles. You can go for review article which are comprehensive, or you can go for a course. Let it be, if you have a material science oriented, you can go for material science synthesis characterization. If you are going to have electronic, you can have electronic design, component design, very large scale VLSI, very large scale integration. Like this, based upon the course, you can always be a selective in terms of research review article. Then how do you identify and study the objectives and establish a hypothesis? So how do we establish? See, for example, the objectives of a research should be directly follow the research questions. So the research questions, in the sense, it should be have exact goals. So what do you want to measure? Which questions need to be answered? So if I consider objectives and goals, definitely you should have a question in your mind. So what are the things we are going to solve in this? So when you are going to make an objective, please be specific. Like olden days, we used to have an accounts note where if a person making any expenses in your home, they'll write in everything in a note. So like expenses note. Like that, you can have a literature research note. You can start writing on it. What are the objectives? So you please write it on your own. What do you want to tell it? So what is the goal? How it should be implemented? So all these things should be collected as a literature. Then you should write it one by one. Suppose if you have some material oriented, so what kind of material you are going to make it as a research proposal? For example, if it is an optical material, you write it as optical material. First, you can write specific classification: magnetic material, ceramics, composites. If you want to go for a nanotechnology, in nanotechnology, what kind of material you are going to use it? Whether you are going to use it for oxide material, or you are going to use it for a non-oxide material, or synthesized by any chemical route or solid methods. Suppose if you are going for electronic design or a component design, what kind of component you are going to make? Whether you are going to make it as a ferromagnetic component, ferrimagnetic component, electrical component, or optical component. So the component device plays a major role. If you are conducting a pilot study, our objectives will be different than of a research. So pilot study differs large extent with that of experimental. The next is, if you are conducting a retrospective research, your objectives will revolve around the described data. So I can have any objectives, but it should confine to the data collected. Suppose I cannot collect data on, for example, as I mentioned earlier, if you are going to work on biological system, for example, vitamin deficiency analysis, if I am going to collect a data for a village, for example, vitamin A deficiency in some village, I can only quantify it in the village domain. It cannot be applied for a rural background data cannot be applied for a urban background, or an urban background data cannot be applied for a rural background. So it always differs. So the model you fit in has to be confined to that data collector. In turn, your hypothesis will follow it. This is especially important when you use statistics such as the statistical value regression analysis. So this will be used for, mainly used for psychology. It depends upon your available resources. Suppose if I am going to have a material synthesis or a chemical layer, I should have a chemistry lab. Obviously, the synthesis lab. Without the synthesis lab, I cannot run a research program. Suppose if I am going to fabricate a component, For example, with electronic background people, if I'm going to have a component, then I'm not going to have it in my home or somewhere where the components can be lost and your morality will be demoralized. So in that sense, we need to have some of the research questions. While raising these research questions, you should have all these things. If you want to have an education base, then you should definitely have a literature analysis based upon it. Suppose if I'm going to have an experimental, then I should have some of the technologies which can be pre-tested or post-tested. In order to determine the actual impact of this test, it should be confined to a group. So it should not be dependent on external resources. Then your time will be wasted. Suppose if you are going to depend on other resources mostly for all the systems, then definitely your research area will become more different. Now, coming to the strategy, you need to have a data collection. There are several methods for data collection in theoretical as well as experimental. Then second thing is sampling. So for this research, you need a sampling and also analysis. So when you are going to make it, you should first define your topic, plan your research model. So whenever you write it like your class lecture notes, you define your topic, you write your research plan, what are the resources, then you outline your outline what are the project that you are going to make it. So if you write it, then it will be more useful for your research proposal. So just like your research paper or a thesis, you should always make a table work. A table work is most important aspect in this case. So like a research paper, journal, or a volume book, whatever it is, you need to concentrate on refining your project. You should define and refine it. I would like to quote one of my professor, Professor P.R. Subramaniam. He is now no more. He is the late Professor P.R. Subramaniam. He used to say the same word. Whenever you find a research article, you again check it, recheck it, again recheck it. Again, you have to make a check for that recheck. So then you will be able to identify some of the research problem. Now going into the strategy. So now we'll go into the strategy straight away. So this is our third part, the third and final part. This is a study and analysis of lightweight, high-speed robotic arms. So this proposal is a sample proposal of science and technology, DST. It is a guideline and it is not a real-time project. It is a guideline project which has been given in science and technology website few years back. And this, I'm using it as a model. So this is given by science and technology itself, right? So here it involves study and analysis. You see, the analysis part is a theoretical model. Studying with the lightweight arm is experimental. So this involves both experimental and theoretical. So lightweight, the name itself says that you are going to have lightweight arms. You are going to have lightweight robotic arms. So since robots and robotics are well known to all the people around the world, I have taken this research proposal as a model. So this proposal is to be used as a guideline, right? You can, if you have any questions, definitely we'll discuss it later then. So now, I think everyone would have seen this robotic arms. In this 21st century, every industrialization process have these robots. So right from industrial, mechanical, electrical, and medical field, you can see this robotic. So generally, I'm classifying broad classification about the subject, right? Here you see that broad subject research problem. Or in the origin of the research problem, I am going to specify in terms of only two paragraphs, which is more than sufficient. If you are going to write about the history, no need to write about pages and pages. Just simply
who has done it, what is the need to go for high payload. So now with this, I have given you some of the mechanical system. It can be 3 joint, 5 joint, or any number of joint. Suppose if I am going to have any of the system, the mechanical system, electromechanical system, now you see that an electronic person is more involved in terms of fabrication of this device. So I am going to have the mechanical system. Next is, I need to decide what is the length of the mechanical system. For example, if I am going to have 5 bend, from the end 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bend, then what is the length of each bend? What is the mechanical system that I am going to make it? What is the electronic? For example, if I am going to have some of the electromechanical system, if I am going to have the payload capacity, then definitely I need to decide. No one is going to. It is up to us. Suppose if it is a hospital, if it is a hospital or an operation theater, we need to specify what is the robotic arms requirement there. So all these things should be considered. Then I need to define what is the experimental parameter, what is the algorithm that I am going to adopt it, then theoretical simulation. So these are the things you need to specify. That's why I told at the beginning, you need to write what is the problem arising there. Then you are going to define the problem. I am going to define in terms of theoretical simulation. Then I can always have what is the algebraic method that is applicable there, what it has been adopted, and what we are going to see in the present investigation. Suppose you see that I have given a graphical representation. You see that now the fabrication not only involves the electromechanical system, but also the mathematical modeling. So if a payload it is going to carry, it can carry between 190 degree and the second payload. For example, we are going to have 5 joints, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 joints. I'm going to have, then the whole system is going to turn around. You see that at the bottom, there is a circle. So you need to design some of the mechanical systems so that I can have a rotator, motor, electromechanical sensors, or motion sensors. This can be a mechanical sensors as well as a motion sensors. So this is for a graphical representation. Of course, this is not related to that project, but for clarification, I have given what is the mechanical system. So the objective of a dynamic model for a two-link serial flexible is, I can have a flexible arm. For example, it can be with a servo motor, but this is a mechanical system where I'm having a fiber reinforced composite with a two motor system. So now, regarding to the international status, an international national status, we need to specify what is the criteria that they have adopted in terms of nationally or internationally. So we have to specify it and give it in terms of a smaller literature review. It can be either a robotic arm with a flexible, it can be an experimental theoretical in combined with it, where I can always cite it in terms of our research area. Then next is, what is the national status? So at present, what is the national status that is existing? So who are all working in this area? So now when I'm going to make it as a citation, I'm going to specify who is the end user. Already we told that who is the end user and what is the need of that research and where it is going to satisfy. For example, if it is a robotic arm, many of the IITs and IISCs, everyone will be working on those areas. So now I'm going to
specify what is the application which is required. Now you see that I am having a robotic arm where it can be applied for a hospital use, or it can be used for any biological areas, or I can use it for many areas. But we need to specify what is the payload capacity. When we talk about the payload capacity, see, the payload differs industry to industry. Now I can always have a smaller payload capacity, a bigger payload capacity,
and in terms of biological application, even it can be a human. So a human can be, they can be even some 70 kilogram, 80 kilogram weight. Now you need to have the payload capacity. So now, so this is what my end user application is. It can be either ISRO or Atomic Research Center, or else it can be an hospital end user. So this is what the payload is meant for. And even it can be in terms of importance. For example, if I'm going to specify which area in this context the proposal is going to be applicable, it can be electromechanical system, nanomechanical system, it can be used for any medical therapy, any of the therapies. Now I need to specify what is the fiber reinforced composite. So what is the application? Like this, you need to specify. See, this is for example, I have given what is the cancer stem cell therapy, the nanofibers, where it is going to use. So like that, I am going to specify it. Now, regarding the review of the expertise, suppose if you are an expert in that area, then we need to specify what are the experts that is available with our group. So what is the advantages that we possess if we are able to establish this research area. So we need to specify about our research area and what are the patents available. So we need to go for the funding agency planning process. If it's going to be, what is the mission, goal, objectives? So what we are going to get there, how we are going to get there. So we have to make a creation. If it is a marketing or sales or industry oriented or any industrial collaboration, we need to specify it. And what does the management and organization gets from all these financial benefits? So when we go for experimental setup and study comparison, you need to give it what is the plan. Now we are going to make it as a two-link, two-rotatory joint, and also study for comparison. So we are going to say, what is the planning? So this is always a planning. So in how many months, whether it is 24 months, for example, I have given this as a 1.5 years. If it is a 3 year or a 2 year, then you have to give it as a time schedule. So what is the schedule activity? If I'm going to, what I'm going to do it in the first 12 months. So on the first month, I'm going to talk with the local representative. If it is a development tools, what is the development tools? How we are going to fabricate. So all these things you are going to look after it. So next is sample selection and with that tox. So then next is pilot study. If you are going to have a pilot study project, definitely you need to have a smaller scale. So these are the some of the scales that you can use, right? Then next is, what is the analysis? So in which part I am going to make this as an analysis? So this analysis you need to specify. So if I am going to make this proposal as a 12 months or 18 months or a 24 months, then we need to specify what is the system that I am going to adopt. So what is the data collection? So how we are going to train a research fellow? So these things we are going to plan a milestone. So obviously this is a planning. And in that planning, you can have a deviation above or below, but that's acceptable. But as a whole, you have to plan it like this. So next is budget estimate. For a normal budget estimate, it could be around 20, 25 lakhs. For example, it could be generally any of the research proposal will be like this. So it will be a budget estimate with salary, consumable, travel. Consumable in the sense we can buy components, smaller component, wires, motors, if it is an electronic component, or if it is a chemical component, you can buy chemicals, whatever consumables, travels, and other costs. So then equipment, if you are going to buy a smaller rotator motor, if you are going to buy a bigger motor, whether you are going to buy equipment in the first year or in the second year, all this depends upon what is the process that you are going to adopt. In some of the projects, definitely we can always have project equipment in the first year. So if it is pilot based study, experimental and theoretical, then obviously you can go for the instrument for the second year. So next is, what is the budget for salaries? The budget for salaries, it can be somewhere around 15,000, 20,000, 25,000. It depends upon what is the norms that government has laid, whether it is science and technology, 20,000, 25,000. If you are going to pay for an attendant, for a smaller attendant, if it is a, of course, I have made it as attendant as 4,000. This is an older proposal format. And obviously, the budget has revised in all these days. This is a model replica, model project for science and technology. So we have just put 9.5 lakhs as a salary. Then, for a consumable, what kind of consumable? If you are going for a foreign exchange rates, whether there is a foreign exchange rate, that you have to specify. Whether you are going to buy it as an imported one or you are going to use as a desi model. For example, if you are going to fabricate on your own, or else you have salary, JRF or attendant, whichever project. Then consumable. Consumable, it can be electronic goods which is consumed or thrown, or a smaller chemicals or a fabrication components. Smaller components, you can always have it. Then apart from that, you have 20% institutional charges overhead. So travel. For travel, you can travel between for conferences, workshops, or else to present your research papers, or to travel and buy components. So next is, if I am going to buy a budget equipment, what is the budget equipment that you are going to buy? So now you can buy a smaller component, motors and data acquisition system, PC controller. Of course, the budget is limited to 19-20 lakhs in this proposal, but as a whole, there is no limit for a budget proposal. It can be 25 lakhs, 50 lakhs or 1 crore. It depends upon what kind of pilot project you are going to make it. So now we make it as a, we make it as a literature bar diagram. We can give it what is the literature survey, what is the component design, experimental design and also validation. The next is, what is the list of facility that is available with the parent institution? So basic amenities and facilities needs to be specified. For example, if the host institution, if a host institution whose project is applied from the institution, whether they are having workshop facility, whether they are electric current, laboratory space, power, AC generation, transportation, computer facilities, all these should be specified. So as a whole, in any of the proposal, this is a general format. The next is final outcome. So now science and technology has funded you. What are you going to do? So final outcome, what will be the deliverables? When a project proposal is funded by a funding agency, science and technology, now I need to specify what is the deliverables I am going to make it. So now, deliverables in the sense, it can be a document, a report, a equipment, it can be a smaller component. Okay, so the deliverables can be a smaller component, equipment, software, a result or an approval. So this is the final outcome. So whenever you are going to make a final proposal, your proposal should cover right from origin of the research proposal. It should cover the introduction, literature, what is the project timeline, schedule, budget, and overall outcome. This is the project proposal, right? So when I'm going to have the outcome, you are going to have a research design. It can be a prototyping, it can be a testing, it can be a measure. So a research can be a basic research, a design, prototyping, testing, and measurement of any quantity. So ultimately, coming to the end of this session, planning lies everything in research. So I want to conclude that when you are going to have a planning, your ultimate planning strategy is going to give you end fruitful result, right? So you have to plan it. And I need to quote one of the instant at this time. So arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached. This is mentioned by Swami Vivekananda. I want to quote this at this moment. Technology, whatever we are developing, is for the world. And it should not be for the man alone. In this world, human being, animals, and trees and plants coexist together. So your ultimate research should focus not only on human nature, but also it should look over the industrial aspects, as well as the hazardous nature should be avoided. For example, pollutions can be avoided. So these are the thrust areas that you can definitely work on. Okay. So thank you.